and a very good evening to you. It's Tuesday the 3rd of January 2017. Welcome to another little live chat and phone-in type show for you this evening, boys and girls, on another one of my... I've got four nights off this week. I've got Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday and Sunday this week as we're coming into the new year. I must say, I thought I had a little bit more time left and I was going to dash to the little boys' room for a little wee before we had a chat this evening and finish my tea. But how wrong I was as the seconds suddenly counted down to zero. Never mind, we're here. We'll go for as long as possible until I need to use a little boys' room. If I start going like that, start moving around, you will know as an early viewer tonight why I'm moving around trying to hold it. I could always play a little bit of music while I disappear, couldn't I? Let's say good evening to some early people with us this evening. Shania's on the Isle of Wight. Good evening, Shania. Lily's in London. Hello, Lily. She came along to the karaoke last night. Wonderful performances last night from you, Lily. I must say, she's the one that her husband left her glasses. We seem to be having a bit of a problem with people's glasses on a Monday and a Friday at the karaoke at Central Station where people keep losing their glasses. Last week, it was Lily's husband who left them on the table. Fortunately, I grabbed them, given to a manager who put them in the safe, which you don't, they've only got a small safe there. They put them in the safe and Lily was... She was reunited with her husband's glasses yesterday. Reunited because it feels so good. Reunited because we're understood. I mean, how many verses do you want? You know. So that happened last night. And last night, at the end of the night last night, I'm packing up and there was a commotion, boys and girls. A commotion. Which seemed to be centred around non-Irish Mary from Ireland, and she lost her glasses last night, and I don't think she found them. So I don't know where they've gone, so do be careful of it. It's usually mobile phones and purses and handbags that go missing in places. So do be careful of your glasses if you're coming to any of the karaokes, all right, my darlings? Good evening to Wayne Martin. Good evening, Wayne. Wayne is also a karaoke host live from the Mirrable Studios. The Mirrable's back. Not only is the Mirrable back, can you notice anything else? Oh, let me turn the star on. I think for the last time, is this star going? Oh, it's still on. Look, it's still on. The Christmas star. We're a little bit sparse in Christmas decorations this year. I hope you haven't taken yours down yet. Very unlucky to take down Christmas decorations before the 12th night. Yes, which is 25, 6, 7, 30, 31, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the 6. You've got another, 3, 6, Friday. I think you've got to take them down Thursday or Friday. I'm not sure which one. They say the 6, though. The 6th is Friday. You've got to take them down on the 6th, not before. Very bad luck. Oh, you've taken yours down already, have you? Oh, dear. Well, I don't know how it works if you was to put them up again just for an extra few days. You may have to avoid the bad luck. Don't be coming to me in a few days' time, right? Because you haven't. Because you've taken your Christmas decorations down and you've had bad luck. Oh, you watch it as you cross that road tomorrow if you've taken your Christmas decoration. In fact, I'm going to actively seek out. I'm going to look in people's windows, which I've been doing for a very long time with my binoculars, to be honest. I'm going to look in people's windows tomorrow and the day after and the day after and see who's taken their Christmas decorations down. And I may be driving past your house as you come out the door. So be very, very careful. Yes, you may notice something new here. Look, a new poinsettia, which is covering the clock, unfortunately. A new poinsettia. Can we just uncover the clock? There we are. That's better. A new poinsettia has been provided. But can you see? You can just about see that on the live stream. You see more on the recording. Which has been kindly provided by the lovely Ray Reynolds. Now, you may remember Ray. Ray is a very, very dear friend of mine. I wish I'd met him years ago, actually. Ray's a very dear friend of mine. And he bought me a poinsettia. It's a poinsettia. I've renamed it a poinsettia. He bought me a poinsettia just before Christmas. I went away to my sister's for a few days, came back dead. Dead as a doornail. And he kindly, without even being asked, boys and girls, he purchased me a new... Oh, hang on a minute. There's a dead leaf. I hope that's not a sign of things. Oh, is another dead leaf. Oh, no. Hope that's not a sign of things to come. He's bought me a replacement Poncietta to see out this season of goodwill, which I think is wonderful. It really is. Anyway, I know we've got a phone caller. I haven't even opened the lines yet, dear. I'm in full flow at the minute. I haven't opened the lines yet. Anyway, let's take a call. Who's on the line? Good morning. Good evening. Oh, it's evening tonight, is it? Good evening. Who is on line one?
Hello, Chris. It's Alexander Pallett, a.k.a. Brittany Bell.
Hello, Alex. Could you just turn us down in the background? I can hear myself coming back. It's really not a pleasurable experience hearing myself, I must say. Eh?
If possible. There we go.
That's better.
Hi. Chris, long time.
Long time no hear. Now, just tell us who you are and how you know me.
Brittany Patel. I knew you from my days at the Black Cat.
Brittany Patel. And I named you Brittany Patel. Has that name stuck? And how long ago is this now?
It's stuck like shit to a fly.
Please, dear, no swearing on this very clean family-based programme, if you don't mind, dear.
That word
God sake. And I'm surprised. I'm surprised at a word like that coming out of your little British Airways mouth. That's what you do, isn't it?
Oh, indeed. I'm now banned from British Airways, by the way.
You're what?
Banned.
You're banned from British Airways?
Yeah.
What did you
do? I got restrained on the British Airways flight.
What did you do?
I got drunk.
Oh, my word. But that's what you do, isn't it? Don't you work on the planes?
I used to, but now I fly Emirates. So, ladies and gentlemen, Emirates www.com.
Ah. Emirates. Now I've got to tell you, Alex, my mate Ronnie, is a big, big Emirates fan. He loves it.
Oh, I love Emirates. They have an onboard bar, and funnily enough, right, they don't allow. Emirates do allow you to get drunk on board.
What? While you're working?
Gosh, no, I don't work on air. I work on private jets now.
Oh, you don't work? Oh, you're not even on Emirates now? I thought you said you was on Emirates now.
No.
Or do they
I've progressed a little bit in my career where I now work on jets that are owned by very rich Arab families.
Private jets. Oh, I'd love one of those. Do you think, could you see me ever having a private jet, Alex, if I work just a little bit harder, perhaps?
Well, if my mother does die, I'm sure I will take you personally with Lee and I, my husband, on the most luxurious holiday. Because, Chris, you are the most fabulous person I've ever met in my entire life.
Please do me a favour. People on here will tell you I'm no good at receiving compliments. I can't do that. Please don't start that all that old rubbish, dear. Anyway, wait. So you work on the private jets now, but you have done British Airways, haven't you?
I work for British Airways, Virgin Atlantic, Fisher Airways, Australia's, and also Air Atlanta. However, I've got a problem, Chris.
Oh, what's your problem? Just a moment. Let me put on my problem-solving hat. Hello. Shall I change my voice now? Hello and welcome to the show today. If you've got any problems at all, anything whatsoever, give us a call tonight and we'll do our best to help you. Let's talk to Alex, who's calling in from London now and has got a problem he wants to talk to us about. Hello, Alex, lovey. What is it I can assist you
Chris,
with?
I've been with my partner for 11 years.
Yes.
My partner and my mum, they argue a lot.
Oh, that's the worst thing ever.
It's very difficult.
And do you
however, because of my mother's age, we're now taking her on a lovely holiday to Gran Canaria.
Right.
Could it be possible for us to actually have a nice holiday without me taking my clothes off?
What do you mean, have a nice holiday without taking
That's
your clothes
very,
off?
Isn't it?
Why would you want to take your clothes off on a, what, in a nudist place, dear?
No, we rented a nice house in the mountains.
Yes.
And the problem is that my husband and my mother, they don't get on. How do I deal with this?
What's that got to do with taking your clothes off?
Because I've got a nurse coming with me. She's very hard.
A nurse?
Yeah, no.
So I'm not matching up the things here. So your mum, you're taking.
I'm explaining myself better.
just a minute. Let me say what I've heard so far. Okay.
Okay.
So you're taking your mum. You and your husband are taking your mum on holiday, right? Your mum and your husband don't get on. You're going to be naked and you're taking a nurse. How do all these things match up with each other? I don't understand, dear.
That's why I ask you to kind of connect the dots.
I'm not understanding this at all, dear. Is this a joke call, dear? This is a serious news-based factual program that I'm trying to make here, dear, for the millions of people that are listening and watching.
I would like to put you on the phone to my mum. Is that possible?
Please do.
Yes, absolutely. Mum, Christmas night, it's here.
And turn me down in the background.
Go.
I can hear myself. Turn myself down.
Down in the background.
You'll have to turn it down, Alex, or you will be disconnected. What is going on there?
Please. I don't want to speak.
Oh, well, you don't have to speak, my darling. If you have any trouble with the two of them, just slap them round the head. That's how to deal with that, my love.
I only have one hand that works, Chris.
Well, just
my
use...
My legs don't work. I have a broken shoulder, which has been broken twice.
Oh, I see.
Fractures. Chris, one hand which is holding the phone.
Yes. Well, I
have no interest in this happening.
Well, put the phone down and give the pair of them a good slap round the head. That'll sort them out. I haven't got time for these youngsters, I'm afraid, Mrs. P.
They're not youngsters.
Oh, they are. Look at them compared to us.
Oh, how old are you, Chris?
53, my dear.
Well, here I am at 70.
Well, good luck to you. That's what I say. You know better than them. Give them a whack round the head.
Why do you waste time talking to people? He said he's known you 17 years. How did that happen?
I've no idea. He just appeared from nowhere and thought he was Britney Spears about 15 years ago.
I tell you what, sweetness yourself. Don't ever accept a call from him. Hey, I'm laughing like a hyena.
I think you're absolutely right. I shall never accept a call. I shall block this number so he can never ring again.
He's upset his partner if I can get a word in here twice. He's upset his partner.
Oh, my darling.
He has upset him.
An absolute pleasure to talk for you, my darling. Thanks for calling, all right?
Absolute pleasure talking with you, Chris.
Cheerio, my darling.
Chris.
Yes.
Happy New Year to you as well.
Happy New Year to you as well. Bye-bye, my love. Good luck to you. There we are. Alex's mum speaking there. We've got another call coming in already. Good morning. Good evening to... Hello, Joe. Joe.
How are you doing, my love?
How lovely to hear you. Good God, my friend. How are you today?
Not too bad. Pretty good. Now, I've got a day off, so I'm pretty happy.
All these people I haven't spoken to for years. Now, I've got to tell you, boys and girls, Joe, I've known even longer than Alex. Must be...
It's at least 25 years.
At least 25 years. And I haven't seen you for 20? Where was the last time I saw... Oh, yes, I remember now.
I came to Putney, didn't I?
That's right, yeah. I think it was...
I come to the Two Brews in Putney and I made a special trip just to come and see you.
No, Clapham. Two Brews is in Clapham.
No. You're right.
Two Brewers is in Clapham, Joe. Hello, Joe. Clapham. Now, Joe, if I remember rightly, you were going to get into politics, weren't you? How old are you now? About 38? 38-ish?
I was 42 3 days ago.
Oh, you're 42 now. Wow. Gosh, isn't that amazing?
I know. It's a bit much, isn't it?
You know when you used to come into the place in Earls Court, Harpo's, that I worked? How old were you then? Yeah. Were you underage when you were coming in there?
Allegedly.
Well, were you or weren't you? I mean, I never know.
Allegedly,
people say...
allegedly. That's all I'm going to say is allegedly.
Oh, come on. We were all too young when we first went in a pub, weren't we? Absolutely, yes.
No. I was too young. I was way too young.
Was you? How old were you then?
I think I was about 13 or 14.
You weren't? Is it really?
Yeah, I don't think.
Do you know, I don't think you'd get past the door now. I think things are much more strict
these days. Because people like card you and stuff.
Who? So
they card you.
Card you? What's that?
Yeah, they ID
you. Oh, yes. We never had anything like that when I was young. So.
Do you know,
the only time... I was ever requested my age was on my 21st birthday, and it was a pub next to the Hammersmith Palais, which is of course not there anymore.
Yeah.
And it was my 21st birthday, and we thought we'll have a drink in there first, and then we'll go to the Hammersmith Palais afterwards. As I say, not there anymore.
Yeah.
And that's
the
only time I was ever age requested. And I told them it was my 21st birthday. And they just believed me. You know, you didn't have to show a bit of paper or anything then. It was so different then, wasn't it, eh?
See, I even remember you working at the Hippodrome.
Yes, I did, yeah. I did.
With Stefan. Stefan used to rise out at the floor.
That's right. Now, how many did I do?
Fucking hell, how many years ago?
No swearing,
sorry,
dear.
I'm into swearing.
No swearing. I think I did about 3 or 4 at the Hippodrome, didn't I?
Yeah.
That's a big casino now, isn't it?
Yeah.
Isn't that a big...
It's like a casino or something.
I think it is a casino. And then a little bit later, many years down the line, I worked in the same sort of area at the Long Island Tea Shop. I DJ'd in there. Did you know that
place? Yeah.
Yeah, that's gone as well now.
I remember that as well.
Gosh.
Remember that very, very well.
Where the time goes, I'm afraid. Thanks, everyone, for your messages. I'll come to those in a minute after we've finished chatting away to Joe today. Now, you're in... whereabouts are you? In East London, I think, aren't you?
No, I'm in Oklahoma now.
You're in Oklahoma, the windy city.
Yeah.
Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain. Oh, I love it. Have you got... Is it like in the films where you've got tumbleweeds going past the shops outside? Is it like that? And people have got guns and are shooting.
Well,
and there's...
it's not far, actually. Really not far.
And horses, especially, and things like that. I thought you were going to get into British politics at some point.
Yeah, I've got into politics here, though.
Okay.
So, I've got into politics here.
Especially
since Donald Trump's fucking...
If you swear once more, I'll have
sorry.
To get rid of you, my darling.
I'm sorry,
everyone. We don't do calls like that. No, we mustn't, dear.
No.
One more swear word. Are you drunk, dear?
No. I wish I was.
Swearing. How are you going to keep in politics if you keep swearing like that?
No.
Now, you know me, Joe. Am I a clean-spoken person when not on the air?
You are. You're perfect.
I'm not, though, am I?
You're totally clean-spoken.
I've got a terrible mouth. But when we're doing a programme, we mustn't swear, dear. We could if we wanted to.
I apologise.
Thank you.
Profusely.
Why are you ringing
really
in, Joe?
Apologize.
Is there something in particular you wanted to talk about today?
No. I just thought I'd phone up and give you a call.
Oh, I think that's brilliant, coming from Oklahoma. Yes. Do you have horses there? Is it all horses? I bet there's no cars. Horses going up and down, tumbleweeds, John Wayne walks past.
Horse and carriages. No, of course there's cars.
Who do you live with out there? Are you on your own or what?
No, with my husband.
Oh, okay. What does he do?
He's retired now.
Oh, right. What did he do?
He was an accountant.
An accountant? Oh, numbers and all that. I'm not good with numbers. Well, I am.
For example,
if you was to owe me 3 new pence, I would remember that. Do you know what I mean? But when it comes to algebra or anything like that, I haven't got a clue. What a waste of time.
I've got a clue.
Algebra.
He's got a clue, but I haven't got a goddamn clue.
You haven't got a clue.
No, sir, I'll stop myself there.
Lovely to talk to you, Joe. Keep us posted about your political career. Is it possible that you could become the next president of the United States of America? Who do you reckon that's going to be? I reckon it's going to be the... what's his name's wife? Oh.
Oh, Obama.
Yes, I reckon it's going to be Michelle Obama. I quite like her. Did you see her on Carpool Karaoke?
Yeah. She was very, very cool.
She's very, very likable, isn't she? And sometimes, she is. You know, sometimes these days, I think it's more important. I hate to say this, but these days, I think it's more important to actually be likable in front of a camera than it is to have good politics.
You're totally right. You're totally right.
So you've got to get yourself
up. Maggie wouldn't have lasted a minute in these days.
No, I don't.
Bless her. God rest her soul.
Oh, God rest her soul, Maggie. See you, Joe. Thanks for calling in.
Thank you very much, Chris.
Bye.
Love
now.
You.
Bye. There's Joe in Oklahoma. All these people calling in today that I haven't seen for heard for ages and ages. How blooming marvellous is that? Sorry about a little bit of swearing going on there, boys and girls. You understand it's live. There's no delay thing here. I won't. There's no point in line. But generally, if I will usually cut people off unless that's it. Okay. Hello to Stuart James Tiberius Franco. Hello, Stuart. What a long name, Tiberius. You've got the same name as Captain James T. Kirk on the Enterprise. When's the next film? Anyone know what the next Star Trek film's coming on? Hello to Danny Davis in Manchester. Simon Keane's with us. Elaine's with us. Hello, Elaine. Peaches and Herb, Reunited. You liked that song, didn't you, Elaine? Did you want the whole song? Oh, no. Okay, then. Well, I won't then. Hello to Paul McIlroy. Tell him to get laser eye surgery. Problem solved. Oh, no, dear. I couldn't have that. I do wear glasses sometimes, Paul. For example, I've got bits of newspaper in front of me here. And that I might find that difficult to read. So I've got these, which cost me £10 from the... I don't have prescription glasses. They're so dear. And my mate Ray Reynolds has got a pair of glasses that he paid £400 for. I bet you're waiting for him to leave them on a table. And I put these on. And these are, that laser eye surgery, it worries me. If they get it wrong, no second chance. You know what I mean? I mean, how safe is it? And we don't know, like, it's relatively new, isn't it? You know, years down the line, how do you know if that's going to carry on working or something else might go wrong? Bit like worries me a little bit, that. Thank you, Paul. still got a bit of a cough. Actually, I'm going to see the doctor next Tuesday. I rang up my special. I've got a specialist doctor. Rang him up and he said to pop in and see him next week. Hello to Kelly. Hello to Joey. Say some people are still taking Christmas stuff down. Foolish people, Joey. Foolish, foolish people. You'll have bad luck. Bad luck. Elaine Wayne says it's not unlucky. It's unlucky to leave them up after the 12th night. Yes, it is, Wayne. It's unlucky to take it down before the 12th night as well. Down or up? Where do you prefer to be? Yes, I thought so. non-Irish Mary from Ireland is with us as well. She said, I did find my glasses. They were stuck in the lining of my coat. Oh, Mary. Do you know that same thing happens to me with keys and tissue and my, what's that called? Asthma thing, which I barely use now. I know I've got this cough. Right, but it's not tightening at all. Do you know what I mean? Sometimes you get a bit of a chest, and it starts to, and that's frightening, isn't it? I know exactly what I mean, and you can't quite catch your breath. I haven't had that problem for a number of years now. Actually, I barely use that blue one. Elaine says, nice plant. Yes, it is, isn't it? Ray Reynolds bought me that, as I say. Lovely plant, that is. Hello to Lou. Hi, Chris. Happy New Year to you as well, Lou. James Bates is with us. Long time since I saw you, James. Are you still in South East London? Around Sidcup area, if I remember. It's years since I've seen you, James. Welcome back. You see, we're still here chatting away. And in high definition as well now. It just gets better and better. High definition. Soon I will be one of those holograms that we'll do a show and I'll suddenly appear in the middle of your living room sitting next to you. Would you like that, Danny Davis, for me to become a hologram next to you in the living room?
Well, I always watch you in the comfort of my bedroom, so that would be a little bit weird.
Well, I mean, I could just, you know, appear, you know, at the end of your bed like a ghost. Do you have ghosts in your house? Do you have ghosts in your house? Sorry, I keep thinking it's still Halloween for some reason. It's the face, you see.
Well, I'm not going to make a comment. But talking about holograms, actually, have you seen those little things you can get on the TV? They're making those R2-D2 models now.
No, I haven't seen that. What's that about?
It's like one of these build every week kind of things. You know, one of these magazines you can buy.
Oh, Partworks, where you like there's like 200 magazines and you buy one a week, paying like £3 a week for one of those. Not actually realising that over the course of the time, you're going to spend £500 on a book. They've got you.
This one is £8.99 and it's over 100 issues.
So you're going to be paying nearly £900. And you, of course, then you've got the binders. The binders are a tenner each, haven't you? Oh, yeah. I used to buy those things when I was younger, in my teenagers. There was a couple. There was one called How It Works, OK? And it was just basically a magazine. Of it, you know, it tells you, like, maybe how does the kettle work? And it would tell you how it works. And that was in loads of bits. Now, there was another one I did as well. Something about, I think it was called All About Science. I wonder if I can find, you know, sometimes you can find these things on eBay, whereas people have collected these things over years and years and they're selling them. Let's type in All About Science. I don't know if that was one. Yes, 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 it's there. So someone is selling those for 120 magazines, £39. Now, these are, I think they're from the 70s. I'm sure they're 1973. And I collected those, but I never completed them, Danny. I would be collecting them, and then I'd get fed up paying out the money. What was the other one I said? How It Works, wasn't it?
Yeah. Why don't you buy the whole set?
Do you remember How It Works? Is that one there? Well, that one's not there.
Isn't that a TV show now, isn't it? It's a TV show now, I think.
Oh,
is.
I don't know. Is that from HTV, that one? No,
it's on like Freeview Channel Quest or something like that, CBS Reality or something like that. It's on the Sky channels.
Okay, now I found How It Works magazines. People are selling them separately, but I can't find a collection of them. So that's great, isn't it? Yeah, so people actually have collected these as children. Collectors always want this sort of thing, you know? If you were actually if you've been collecting this stuff as a child, because we all collect things, don't we? Mike says, hello, Chris, lovely to see you live. Been watching your shows. The TV show is called How It's Made, apparently, Mike says. All right?
Yeah, that's the one.
Thank you. You have been corrected. You like a bit of correction, don't you, Danny?
Well, that's another chat for another show, maybe.
Anyway, what do you want to chat about tonight, my friend? I've chatted enough. Go.
Just literally about this whole Christmas decorations and.
Oh yes.
I took mine down today.
Oh, Danny, terrible thing might happen to you tomorrow. Now, dear, I wouldn't leave the house. Don't leave the house. Don't leave the bed. Turn off the water, the electric, the gas, and don't turn anything on until Friday.
Well, the thing is, you know, I was going to make a comment about you in the pool because that made me laugh.
What do you mean?
When you were in the pool, you nearly got electrocuted.
Well, I did. Thank you for watching that show. I nearly got electrocuted 2 days ago. And I haven't even got any Christmas. This is the Christmas decoration this year. The one star, which was lighting up, but I've realised the batteries have gone dead now. But that's okay because they're rechargeable ones. Oh, yeah.
There's another question I wanted to ask you as well.
Yes,
what was that
please do. Is it personal? I hope it's not personal. I can't be sharing my personal life here with the millions of people tuning in at this moment.
Well, what was that blue thing covering the mirror ball?
What was what?
That blue face that was covering the ball, mirror ball.
That was a Christmas decoration as well, sort of. But it's not. It's not really a Christmas decoration. I have it here in front of me. It is this little blue furry thing. Now, I found this. I discovered this when I went on holiday to to Yorkshire this year, and we went to a place called Scarborough with my niece and her husband and her two children, George and Emily. And we're going past the shop, and I saw this, and it was only a couple of quid. And I thought that would be nice to hang up in place of the mirror ball for Christmas. And so that's what that is. Do you like it? Would you like it? It's all nice and fairy. It's a ball. Look, listen. It's a ball, and it bounces, and you could play football with this. What you could do is I could send this to you. Have you got an ex that you hate? Or someone in your life that you hate. Well, you could pretend that this is that person and then kick it around. How fabulous would that be?
There we go.
I thought you might like that.
We could make a business out of that.
Yes. What a good idea. You could actually, what you could do is advertise to make balls, right, with people's faces on that you hate. My God, I'd have a room full of them. I'm going to have a room full of them. Mike says, I'd love that fairy ball, Chris. Would you now, my darling? I might be able to send that to you, Mike. Maybe we should have some sort of competition or something like that where we'll give that away.
Talking about giving things away.
Yes.
These mugs that you said you were going to give away like 3 months ago, four months ago.
I haven't got round to that yet, dear. I'm sure that will happen at some point when I get around to these things. So much to do, dear. So much. Busy. I need a nice secretary or something like that dealing with
things. I was just going to offer my services.
Would you? But you're up there. Yeah. You're in Manchester, home of Coronation Street. Oh God, so boring that tune.
I can do it all online.
Oh, could you really?
Yes.
Oh, but I'd have to pay you, and I don't like paying people for anything. Oh, here's a message. Mike says, "How much are you offering? How much for the book? Oh, he wants to pay for it. Say your price. I'll buy it off you. He wants to pay for it, dear."
No, you got to keep it. It's been in the Mirabeau studio, so it's got to be kept in the studio.
Do you think so? Do you think it's got to be kept in the studio?
Yeah.
It can't go up again now, though, because that's it. Christmas is over. It's not really a Christmas decoration, so that it can't be included in the don't take your Christmas decorations down, because it's a summer thing. It's actually a summer thing. But I thought it would be nice to have something different other than the Mirabeau. We were going to put a globe up there, but people preferred the Mirabeau, so that's why the Mirabeau is staying in its position.
Well, the Mirabeau's been there for years, as long as I've known you.
Yeah, he is. Mike is actually begging for the ball now. Look, I'll buy it off you. No, I want to buy it. Oh, he wants to buy it off me. Oh, Mike, I can't accept charitable donations. I really can't. But that's why. Do you know all these people? They keep setting up GoFundMe projects. I heard a friend of mine told me that someone he knew wanted a new... now what are they called? An Apple laptop. Now what's that called? A Mac. He wanted a Mac, so he set up a GoFundMe thing so he would get a new Mac. I don't know if anyone generated any money or sent any money through or anything like that. They're all at it, dear. They're all at it, trying to make money. Ah, now I found out the reason Mike wants the ball. I want it because it's been handled by my favourite man. Would you like to be handled by a man?
Who, me? I've been fondled by many men.
Oh, Chris. Stop it. I'm going to cut you off for that. Goodbye. Gone. Please, it is a family-based program. Keep it clean. You never know what time people are watching this program. They could be watching it in the afternoon or in the morning. Little people all at the breakfast table. Perhaps I could become your breakfast show. Would you like a breakfast show every morning at 6 o'clock in the morning? I don't think so, dear. No, I'm either asleep at that time or I've woken up to have a wee. One of the two. Oh, isn't that strange? I don't want to go to the wee anymore. It hasn't leaked out somewhere, is it? Or something like that. Thank you. Hold on to your calls for a bit. Let's do some of the messages that have been coming in today. Coming in on the show today. I think I can only go back so far, actually. I don't seem to be able to. Oh, there's a couple here. James says, hi, Chris. Take it with you. Take it you will be doing the shows regularly. Still, sorry it's been a long time, but last year wasn't a good one for me. Ah, the cat died. James, your cat died. I know you were very fond of that little cat, weren't you, my darling? I'm sorry to hear that. Then Mum. Oh, I don't know what to say to you, James. I'm sorry your mother died. I really am. But I'll be around to see your show a bit more. I'm still in South East London. I'm so sorry, James. You've had a bad year last year, especially when your mum dies. Mums are very special, aren't they? But I would say to you, I don't think it's something you get over, a parent dying, especially boys and mums. There's something that, you know, it's like dads and daughters, boys and mums. There's something extra there, isn't there? Don't you think? And I would say to you, it's something you don't get over. You just learn to live with it. All right, my darling? And good luck to you, James. Thanks for sending the message in there. Lots of love to you, OK? Hello to Stella, who said, just to let you know, it's Chi-Chi, that cat. Oh, she's got a cat as well. Stella's got a cat. Chi-Chi is 18. Oh, not as old as my cat. My cat's older than that. But happy birthday to Chi-Chi, the cat. Stella's cat there. Lovely. Now, let's see if we can go back a little bit further. I think I'm not sure I can go right back to the beginning of the messages there, so I might miss some of these out now. Stella also says, we've known each other for 28 years. How long is that? God, 28 years. Good evening to Johnny Key. Wendy's with us. Wendy, hello, Wendy. Alex, Wendy's there as well. I said that three times now, haven't I? Alexander says, don't judge my drinking. Who's judging, dear? Who's judging? Joe is with us. Michael Doan. Hello. Happy New Year to Michael. All right. Chicago is the windy city. Woo, woo, woo. Alexander says, can we have some George Michael? No, we don't do music on here, I'm afraid. We don't do music on it. It's a chat show. It does make me laugh. Sometimes people send me a message saying, you go on a bit. Well, that's what it is. It's a chat show. We talk, dear. We talk. Elaine says, I tore myself away from MTV to log into the show. To MTV, Elaine. Oh, come on. I don't do music videos. Isn't that funny? I can never sit down and watch a music video. And all the new ones. Have you noticed, Elaine? All the new music videos, they're just full of scantily clad people. I mean, we can't have that going on. Not here in England, dear. You know, every time I turn on, there's some very tanned woman on with very large bits and pieces, and they're gyrating in a pair of tiny bikinis on my television. I'm not having it, dear. I quickly switch back over to the BBC News Channel. Thank you very much, Elaine. Ray Reynolds is with us tonight. Hello, Chris. Merry Tuesday to you as well. Anything else here? Have I got any travel? Ross wants to know, have I got any travel plans in 2017? yes, indeed, but they're all UK. They're all UK. I've discovered caravan holiday last year. And what I like about caravan holidays is that it's your own home from home. You get your key. It's a house. There's your own kitchen, bedrooms, showering. Sometimes you've got a bath in there, all central heated. I love caravans. You get in your car, you drive for a couple of hours and you're there. No mucking around at airports or anything like that. So all UK this year. I will at some point go back to Israel. I was very, very taken with Israel. Fantastically country, full of so much history and interesting things. I myself became a piece of interesting history when I went to Israel. I really did. So thank you, Ross. Let's have a look here. We'll go to the top. We'll go back to the top there. Then we can get more up to date with the messages. MTV, I beg your pardon, Eloise. MTV, Manilow TV, I beg your pardon. Thank God you're not sitting there watching that trash that is otherwise known as modern music. People like Beyonce. I mean, it was crazy and Love was all right. Love on top. But that drunken love, what a... And rapping, dear. What is all that about? Every time I push my on button, there's some bloke with a vest on. And they don't even dress in suits, do they? They said there'd be some bloke on the telly in like a baseball outfit with some shorts or trousers hanging halfway down his arse, a gold chain on, and he's like... talking. I mean, what is that about? I don't even understand what he's saying. My nephew loves it. My nephew loves this talking music known as rap. Oh, no, not from Manilow TV. Oh, my God. There's my nephew at the top there. That's Jimmy Butler. That's my nephew. Panda. Thank you, Jimmy. Panda, which is like rapping music. Let me see if I can find a tiny little bit of I thought it was a, I thought he'd been started working at a zoo when he said to me, Panda. Hang on. Let me see what happens if I... Panda rap. Let's try this. See if I can find it. Here we go. Right. This is the sort of thing my nephew likes, okay? I'm just going to play you a little snippet of this. My nephew loved this stuff. Here we go. What is... But that is... Isn't that hideous? For God's sake. Do you know, when I was when myself and my nephew went to Florida last year, 2 years ago now, wasn't it? I practically begged him to come to that Barry Manilow concert. Nope, but he weren't having it. He weren't having it. Instead, he prefers to listen to Panda. Dreadful, dreadful. Stella says, get yourself a motorhome, better than a caravan. No, when I say caravan, I mean static caravans, not one you tow around. Now, I couldn't have my own caravan, and I couldn't have a motorhome. And I tell you why, I could not deal with the toilets. Oh, my God. You have to empty your own toilet. No, thank you. Now, I've looked this up. I gather there are cassettes that you can buy, not audio cassettes that you can buy that work, kind of work the toilet, and they close up automatically when you've finished doing your thing. But they've still got to be emptied, dear. They've still got to be emptied. And I've been, like, the static caravan sites I go on also have facilities if you've got, like, your own tow-around caravan. And I've seen the areas you use where you dump your, you know, you dump your human waste. Not for me. There is no way I'm going to have a caravan and have to empty my own toilets. And now, on a boat, if you've got a boat, and I've been on a boat before, many, many years ago, I was on the Norfolk Broads, 30 odd years ago. And there, when they empty the toilets, this man comes with a thick hose thing and attaches it, and he pushes a button and it's just sucked. God, it makes me feel ill, this is. Oh, God. All the waste is sucked out of the boat into some sort of tank somewhere, and nothing has to be touched. Now, I could do that. But I don't think that's how it works with caravans. You have to pull out a cassette and empty it somewhere. Oh, no, I'm not talking about this anymore longer. Oh, it's awful. Dreadful, dreadful, dreadful. Hello to Jerry Green. He's with us tonight. Hello, Jerry. Oh, dear. Lily. Lily says... I can't remember what we were talking about then, Lily. That's a while ago. Yes, I like it, Chris. I found one. Oh, yes, my book. Do you mean my fairy ball, which is over here? Hang on a minute. I'll get it again. I'll get my fairy ball out again. It's particularly to tease Mike. To tease Mike, because he wants this. He wants my fairy ball, don't you? Lily says, I like it. I found one like that in my shop. My husband says, plays my head instead. Oh, how awful. Now, Mike says, I was watching Wheeler Dealers, then I saw you were live. Happy days. Oh, thank you very much. That's very kind of you to say. Simon says, rap music, the sea is silent. Sir Chop Chop of... The sea is silent. What sea? Rap music. Sea. There is no sea in rap. What are you going on about, Simon? Please speak so that we can understand what the hell you're talking about. Please, dear. And it's dab as well. Dab. Is that the name of a dab? Is that the name of another rap artist? Or is that the type of music, Jimmy? Do let us know. Is your girlfriend with you tonight? He's got a lovely girlfriend, my nephew. Her name's... Oh, I've just bit my lip. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. I'm speaking too quickly. Is it bleeding? Is it bleeding? I hope my lip's not... Just a moment, please. Let me use the second-hand tissue. Just a moment. That's a bit malignant. No, it's not bleeding. He's got a lovely girlfriend, Charlotte. She's thin. So thick. See this pencil here? This United Kingdom talk pen as sent to me by a very, very nice listener and viewer. See, she's thinner than that pen. She's a beautiful girl and her name's Charlotte. Come into my web. Charlotte's web. Do you like that? Do you like that story? Yes. Elaine says, do you have any other furry balls besides the... Elaine, I'm very disappointed, Elaine. Very disappointed in that comment, my darling. Very, very disappointed. Danny Davis says, are you the next Parky? What, as in Parkinson? No, he's far too serious for me. Far too serious. Now, let's have a look here. I wanted just to read out a couple of emails that we missed out on yesterday's show, actually. Joanne Evola. Who is in, I think she's in Michigan. I can't remember now. Anyway, we'll come to the emails. Says, I'm so glad you survived the electrocution in the swimming pool incident. Yeah, me too. I nearly died in the pool, the swimming pool the other day. Do you not know what happened? Well, you've missed a show. I told you before, you miss a show, you miss it all, dear. Anyway, she says, I was just getting to know you. I would truly miss you. Oh, miss you like crazy, miss you like crazy. Oh, it's a lovely song, isn't it, that one? You missed my messages from yesterday. Please read them. Yes, sometimes, oh, gorgeous one, we don't read the messages on the next day. Sometimes I do miss them. Sometimes I do miss them, but generally I pick them up a bit later on. Okay, so don't worry if your message, if you haven't heard them and a week goes by, start worrying. You know, start sending me really nasty emails. How dare you? And all that business. I spent time doing my emails. Here they come from the other day then. Joanne Evola says, I would thoroughly love for you to stop by and visit you. I would have tea and cakes ready. This lady is in the USA. Tea and cakes ready. Oh, what sort of cakes, by the way? What sort of cakes would they be? Because we can't have any old sort of cakes, dear. No. Or if you still have your fudge, which my sister made, I'll come to that in a moment. You can bring it with you, but it doesn't seem like you have any left. No, I haven't. I've eaten all the fudge that my sister made me for Christmas. My sister does wonderful, wonderful Christmas present that she does me involves fudge usually and homemade marmalade. Which I have on my gluten-free bread. Yes, with a little bit of Lurpak butter. You're getting hungry now. Stop reaching for the biscuits while you're watching this programme, if you don't mind. For your information, I'm not a religious extremist. That was, I was a bit concerned because her surname is Evola. And I thought it was Ebola. When I first looked, I thought it's Ebola. I thought she might have been a religious extremist about to send me a test tube of a nasty virus through the post. God's sake, we've got enough viruses to deal with here as it is, my dear. I'm not a religious extremist. Thank God for that. I may send you a gift and a padded bra, though. Oh, how strange. I love karaoke and would join you, but it's a bit of a trip over to the UK. She said, when I mentioned yesterday that I lived in Michigan, did I say Michigan or Minnesota? Michigan, yes. When I lived in Michigan, you didn't seem to know where it was. Maybe my mistake, Chris, but I lived in Detroit, Michigan, home of Motown music. Calling out a brand new world. Are you ready for a brand new day? Baby love, my baby love. Superstition. Everyone loves Motown. Everyone loves Motown. I've lived there most of my life until it got bad due to drugs and gangs. Oh, we've all heard those stories. Isn't that sad? How such a wonderful place can get ruined by gangs and drugs and all that business. But I'll always consider myself a Detroiter. City with the best music. Just a little information. Thank you very much for sending that through, my darling. So we all know exactly you are a Detroiter. I'm actually a Londoner. I don't live in London now, but I was born and raised in London, South East London, and then South West London. I started, I was born in Wimbledon, and I was adopted. And my mum and dad brought me up in Peckham, where they also adopted a little girl, my sister, Sharon. And then we moved to Roehampton in southwest London. And really, that's where we grew up, in Roehampton, from 1969 till about 1983. When I got married, of course, that didn't work out. Within a year, that all went wrong. So I then went back to live with my mum, mum and dad. And then I went to, I bought my first flat in Wandsworth after I got divorced, bought a flat in Wandsworth. And now I live out in Bracknell. So that's my jumping around the place. I'll probably always be here, I think. I can't see me ever move it. I like it here. I like it here. I've got a lovely house. It's not massive or anything, but it's certainly big enough for one person. You know, got a nice, lovely garden. I love the garden and everything's close, really. I'm going to London I go to London for work, rarely for any other reason. I wouldn't want to live in London at all now. Sometimes people do say to me, you know, it would be a lot easier if you lived in London. You'd get to your jobs much easier. But I wouldn't want to live in London again. No, thank you. Oh, God, the traffic. Too many people and trouble and things like that there. So, no. Stella says, my mum used to complain about the music you played in the Black Cat back in the early 90s. How could she say such a thing, dear, about our wonderful music? James says, I think I've read that one already, haven't I? Yes, I've read that one already. I'm sorry, I'm becoming a little bit confused, dear boys and girls. Let me see. Let's go back to our messages. Hello to Paul Dow, who's with us today. Hello, Paul. When are you coming back to our karaoke nights, dear? Paul, yes. Do you still drive a 4x4? No. I've got what looks like a 4x4, but it isn't. I've got a RAV4 now, which I've had for a few months now. Best car I've ever had. I love it. I absolutely love it. And it's my first automatic car. There's no gear if you're in America. There's no stick shift or anything like that. It's hybrid as well. So part electric, part petrol. And I get about 52, 53 miles an hour. I'm an economical driver. I don't tear up and down motorways or anything like that. I'm the black... you know when you're on a motorway... Oh, should we put the phone number out? If anyone wants to call in now, we will officially open the lines now. If you're watching the show live, a little thing will come up now with the phone number under it. Look at that. If you're watching a recording, no phone number, because obviously you can't record, we can't call in, okay? So if you want to call in, there's a local London number up there. It's 020-8144-3477, okay? 020-8144-3477 is the phone number. If you've got Skype, you can Skype in. My Skype in username is all one word, United Kingdom Talk, okay? So the Skype in number, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Phone number 020-8144-3477. All I ask is that you don't swear. You never know who's listening. It might be children listening or something like that. Please don't swear. If you swear, you'll be the one that looks stupid, not me. And I'll cut you off straight away. If you swear accidentally, yeah, okay, I'll let that go. But if you just come on to swear specifically, cut you off straight away and that's it. Good evening to Anne Taplin, who says she needs a wash. Do you, darling? Oh, well, have one, love. Go on, force yourself. Turn that tap on and force yourself to have a wash, Anne. I think she's talking about something else there that I haven't picked up on. I'm not quite sure. Simon Keane says, no town like Motown, although Cougar Town is a close second. Are you a cougar fan, Sir Simon? Do you like cougars, do you? There's plenty of those around, dear. So, no, Alex, I don't have a 4x4. It's a RAV4, which I love very much. Let's have a look. Fudge. Oh, yes, fudge. That's right. I finished my two bags of my sister's fudge. Sorry. I finished my two bags of my sister's fudge, Alex, and it was absolutely beautiful. Vectis says, was the swimming pool incident shocking? It could well have been. I'm lucky to be here. I am. Stella says she sells loads of these United Kingdom Talk type pens in her shop in Benidorm. She's in Benidorm. Is it warmer in Benidorm generally? You know, I used to think, I don't think I'd do it now, about the moving to another country. I would like to move somewhere where it's never cold. I mean, there's plenty of places like that. When I say never cold, obviously, you know, if you're in very hot weather most of the time and then it goes down to like 60 degrees, that would feel cold there. 60 degrees Fahrenheit, 20 degrees I don't know, 20 degrees centigrade. That would then feel cold to you, but it would never get free. I don't like snow and ice. I hate it. I hate snow and ice and coldness like that. All right. So let's have a look. Ah, no, Anne says, no, the car needs a wash. Oh, it's had a wash now. That's right, Anne. The car has now had a wash, but that was a week ago and now it's dirty again. That's awful, isn't it? Awful. That's because of the fog. You've only got to have a bit of fog, drive through that, and your car is all dirty again. It's disgusting and filthy. Israel has great weather, as I well know, Elaine. As I had a lovely, lovely time in Israel, didn't I, my darling? Some messages from the show yesterday I just wanted to read out. If I can just come over to those. One second, my darlings. Let's just come out of that. Of course, people like to leave messages. Oh, I had that up there yet then. Just a second. Where's that gone now? Yesterday's show. Where are we now? Yesterday's show. Thank you very much to Kevin Webster, who sends in a couple of pictures of a very, very young-looking Barry Manilow. Thank you very much. As you can see, we have Barry Manilow here. I'm a massive Barry Manilow fan. Massive, not as massive as of some people like Anne, who's with us this evening on the show, who has been literally hundreds of times to see Barry Manilow's wonderful shows. Actually, where does he... perhaps you'll be able to answer me this. Oh, and hello to Dahl's Buffett, who's on a small island in the South Pacific, Norfolk Island, which I've visited twice. And it's just a stunning place. And she particularly likes the fact that I was wearing green and yellow yesterday. And she says they are real Aussie colours. Now, I thought it was blue. I don't know. I'm thinking of the flag colours. Now, that's not red and blue and yellow, is it? Yellow and green. Is it the football colours or something in Australia? Thank you, Dials, for that, who also wishes us a happy new year. Tiny little island, Norfolk Island in the South Pacific. You ever get a chance, go and see it. That's a quiet holiday. Yeah, quite lots to explore there, but a quiet holiday. Don't go looking for nightclubs. Nothing like that, dear. But they do like a drink on that island, OK? And hello to Tony Power, who also wishes us a happy new year. So happy new year to you, Tony. OK? How do I know Simon Keane? He popped up as a viewer, really? He popped up as a viewer once, and that's how I know Simon. Okay, that's the only way I know Simon, as he popped up as a viewer and a karaoke fan, and became a friend like that. What do I think of the new £1 coin? Oh, isn't it lovely? It's got lots of sides. Because apparently, up to a third... Did you know this? I'm quite well informed tonight, aren't I? Very, very well informed tonight. Apparently, a third of the £1 note, not £1 note, a third of the £1 coins in circulation, I heard this the other day, are fake. Did you know that? And isn't it funny? No one ever checks, do they? You know, when you go to a shop, like, you know, you might have a £5 note or a £10 note, and they put it under that machine, you know, the X-ray machine or whatever it is, the ultraviolet thing, put it under there. No one picks up the pound coin, starts looking around the edge to see if it's worn off, no, anything like that. No, nope, that's okay. They just take it off you and shove it in a thing. Up to a third of them are fake. So they've got to change them. I do like the look of the new pound coin. I hope they're nice and shiny and round, dear. With all those sides on them, yes. Good evening to Ashley. Hello, Ashley. Just to let you know, Ashley, just in case you were thinking of going down there, the Sydenham karaoke is now finished. All right, my darling. We're going to do once a month there now on a Sunday. And the first one will be Golden Lion Karaoke in Sydenham on Sunday the 5th of February. And it'll be open mic as well. Okay, open mic as well. So if you want to bring down an instrument... You know, not a medical instrument, dear, like an organ or a guitar or something like that. We can plug you in and you can come and entertain people, OK? Simon says he loves a cougar. Yes, I suspect you do, dear. Mike says, what do you suspect for 2017? Do you think we will lose more celebrities? Well, I hope not. I hope not. I really, really hope not. I, you know, we lost so many last year, didn't we? I mean, I think the biggest shock of all last year was what was George Michael, because I think it's because it was on Christmas Day. I was actually sitting, because some news items, if there's a news flash, it flashes up on my phone, right? So I can see myself. I have two cameras here. There's one there, that's the recorded show, okay? And there's one there, that's the live show. OK, so they're recording the same thing, but for different purposes, really. And I was recording my show on Christmas. It was Christmas night, wasn't it? It was about 11:30. And suddenly this thing flashed up on there. And I didn't comment at the time, But it was a real shock. So I hope we don't lose too many. We'll probably lose some, I expect, but not too many. Not as many as this year, anyway. Terrible, terrible. Right. Ladies, bad news, ladies. Bad news, ladies. And bad news, some of the boys. Cristiano Ronaldo has a new girlfriend. I wait so long for a phone call from Cristiano. I mean, I've made it clear on this programme that I'm sure he watched. Most of the world now tunes into this show. Did you know that? But anyway, every time they've been spotted lately, they've been packing on the PDA. What does that mean? It says in today's Daily Mail, packing on the PDA. What does PDA mean? What does that mean? You see, I do hate that when people use abbreviations. How many times have you been reading a newspaper or seeing captions come up on the telly and you get some sort of abbreviation and you don't know what it is? You don't know what it is. UKT. UKT, isn't it? What is UKT? United Kingdom Tour. But I don't say that, do I? We use the whole word, dear. It says, Cristiano Ronaldo and his new girlfriend, Georgina Rodriguez. have cut steely figures as they strutted from a private jet to a car. What does that mean, strut? Is that like this? Just a moment, please. I'll give you a quick demonstration. I'll start over there. Is this strut? cutting steely figures as they strutted from a private jet to a car. Oh, I wonder if Alexander, have you had Cristiano Ronaldo on one of your private jets? How exciting would that be? The 31-year-old footballer was seen marching from a large vehicle with tinted glass. I've got tinted windows on my car, on the back, yes, to their hotel in Madeira. I wonder if it was a travel lodge. Do you think Cristiano Ronaldo stays at travel lodges or Premier Inns? What do you reckon? And there he is. Now, what's he got on there? He's got the strangest boots on. Oh, there she is with the girlfriend. And he's looking at the girlfriend. Oh, dear. You're wasting your time with these people. I'm sorry. I think Christian, he looks a bit gay, doesn't he? Don't you think? Don't you think he just looks a little, just perfect hair, you know, plucked eyebrows and that body, you know, which is actually similar to mine. Cristiano and I have very, very similar bodies. I know you find that hard to believe. It's a bit difficult, well, of course, when I'm dressed up nicely. I do apologise to my conservative friends today, but I do have a red shirt on. It's a bit labourless, isn't it? A bit labourless. Sorry about that. Yes. I still think at one point he will make a phone call to me. Stella says, no, Chris, to strut your stuff, you need to swing your hips much more. Well, I've got them big enough. The hips are big enough. They really are. PDA means public display of affection. Well, why don't they just say that, Eloise? PDA. What does that mean? No one knows what that means except you. Do you do public displays of affection? My mate Ron and his other half, Andy, Andy hates public displays of affection. They won't hold hands or anything. Oh, dear. Sarita says, are you a hissing cat now? Yeah, I do a very good hissing cat. Would you like it again? Here it comes. Would you take a photo of it. Do a quick screen grab. All right, you ready for this? Here it comes. After 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's my hissing cat, Sarita. You're impressed with that, aren't you? You're so impressed with that. Simon says he's also a karaoke host in Stoke. He does his own karaoke nights out there, OK? Now, what else have I got to chat to you about today? Let me see here. I had a little story here. Oh, yes. Now, are you... This is in today's... my favourite paper, the Daily Mail. Oh, you don't read the Daily Mail. Yes, I do read the Daily Mail. That's me, the Daily Mail I read. Deserted shopping malls. Now, did you go into any of the sales? Now, I must say, I did go to the sales, but it was for my nephew. He wanted a pair of trousers in Lincoln, so I went there with him on Boxing Day, and he bought this pair of trousers, got them home, there's holes in the knees. And he says, oh, that's how they're supposed to be. Imagine that. buying a pair of trousers with holes already in the knees. My mum used to sew those up. If I got holes in the knees, what on earth is all that about? Buying trousers with holes in the knees. Anyway, the number of bargain hunters at shopping centres on New Year's Day has plunged, but plunged like a knife into a back, has plunged by half in just 1 year as more of us now shop on the internet. This could signal the end of the January sales tradition as shoppers go online for cut price deals long before the New Year rush, retail analysts warned yesterday. Did you buy anything, incidentally? Did you buy anything in the January sales? Let me know what you bought, okay? And did you intend to actually buy those items? Or did you think, oh, I'll just go shopping for a bit? And you went out and, oh, I'll have that and I'll have that. And then a little bit later, did you get home and think, oh, why did I buy that this year? Let me know if you bought it. Call in if you want and tell me about that. 0208 144 3477. We're looking for new callers tonight. If you've never called before, give us a shout. It's a local London number. Won't cost you any more than a normal phone call to London, OK? 0208 144 3477. Footfall, which is the number of people who browse on in a shop in a given... Oh, they hate that. Actually, staff in shops hate that when you browse and buy nothing. Don't they hate that? And don't you get fed up with them? Can I help you? No, I'm just looking. Well, what are you looking for? Don't know. Oh, you must know. No, don't know. Looking. Go away. That's why we go online to buy stuff. Because we haven't got some jumped up blooming shop assistant forcing us to try and force us to buy something, dear. The number of people fell by nearly half at shopping centres and retail parks on Sunday, while a drop of 12.7% was recorded on the high streets. So a hell of a lot of less people visiting shops now. I must say, I do all my virtually all my shopping is done online now. I love it when you order something and then the next day or a couple of days later, you get my bling! On a very loud ring I've got on my bell, which I installed personally. Chris Ridden DIY. Thank you. Bell installed. Bing! My mate has now got a video doorbell. Oh, it's very, very good. Right? And it's made by a company called Ring. If you type in Ring video doorbells, okay, I got him this for Christmas. And so you come along, you push the button, and this activates. I like that word, activates. It activates the camera, which ding comes on, okay? Unbeknown to the person who's pushed the button. And then on his mobile phone, up comes a picture of the person, wherever he is in the world, a picture of the person. Not only that, he can actually talk to the person from his mobile phone. How fantastic is that? Eh? And this morning I've been out with him all day, actually. I've had quite a nice day today. I've been driven around by my mate. We've been to various places. I didn't need to go anywhere, but he had to go to Booker's, which is like a wholesale place, to pay some money. And then we went to, where did we go after that now? Then we went to Sunningdale. Now, what did he have to do there? Oh, yeah, he had to get a quote because he's got some damage to his BMW. So we had to go to Sunningdale. Oh, South Ascot. That's it, South Ascot. Then we went to Sunningdale to Waitrose, done a bit of shopping there. And we found this little tea place, which was ever so nice. So comfortable, nice and warm, nice seats and all that. And we had a cup of tea each and a little cake each. £9.50, dear! Two cups of tea and a couple of bits of cake. £9.50. God, I nearly fell through the floor. Anyway, I opened my wallet, blew the dust off a £20 note and gave it to her. Begrudgingly, admittedly. But it was lovely and comfortable in there. So we sat there for a while and then I came home, had a sleep, got up, made a cup of tea and then come to talk to you. That was my day. Oh, and I've been swimming as well today. The cat's cat. I think I'm going to have to take the poor cat to the vet, actually. She's moaning a lot at the moment. I don't know. I think she might be in pain. I'm not quite sure if she's in pain or not, but must be looked after. Must be looked at by the vet, I think, to see if there's anything that can be done. She's got a bit of a growth on her chin there, and I don't know if that's hurting her. Last time it's been there for a few years, but it's recently I've noticed it's starting to get bigger now. And the vet said that they couldn't really do anything about that. So I'll take her there and see what happens. Anyway, back to this story here. While shops were less busy, internet sales rose 6.8% on New Year's Day and 16.2% on New Year's Eve. The cold and wet weather, along with reduced... Oh, it has been cold. Oh, it was cold last night, dear. Oh, but it's going to warm up a bit, according to our favourite weatherman, Thomas. Thomas the weatherman. Thomas. He's all right, any old Thomas, dear. Looking a bit old now, I'm afraid. He's been there a few years. We need something younger to look at. I think I could do the weather. I'd quite like to do the weather. But none of these graphics. I want to go back. I want to go back to when they had the little magnetic things that would stick on the wall, and sometimes they would fall off. Do you remember that? I think it was Michael Fish. He's the one that didn't predict the hurricane that came in 1987. And he had these little magnetic things. And once, I don't know what happened, I reckon someone had fixed it. And he was trying to put these things on, and none of them would stick on the mat behind him. That's what I need to go back to. I could be a weatherman. We wouldn't do it as normal, though. No, we'd muck about with it a bit. We would muck about with it. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the weather, you excited people. Are you expecting sunshine today? No chance whatsoever, I'm afraid. You know, the weather would be done like that, excitedly. Not like some, you know, some young, good-looking man or some blonde girl pushing herself out like that. Oh, hello, and welcome to the weather. No, 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 we need entertainment, dear. Entertainment, that's what we need. Back to the story. High Street footfall on New Year's Eve also fell. So there we are. We're all shopping online. And it's so easy. It's so easy. But have you overstretched yourself? I told you not to do that, didn't I? I told you every year, if you can't afford a Christmas present, don't buy it. Don't borrow the money or anything like that. Very bad. Because you've got to pay it back eventually. Yes, you have. Don't borrow money. People borrow money for holidays and Christmas. Very, very bad. Only borrow money for two things. House and car. That's it. House and car. The only time you should ever borrow money. Want a sofa? Save up for it. Get your little self a piggy bank and put a few coins in there. The new £1 coins will fit nicely into your piggy bank. And please, when I set up my GoFundMe page, I will be offering you to send your unwanted money directly to me, which will go to a good cause. A new mirror ball, possibly. One that actually lights up or something like that. I don't know. Let's see. Thank you very much to Stella, who has now sent me in a picture of me acting as a hissing cat. Thank you, Stella, who says, I'm still living in Brighton and Benidorm. Oh, you're still living in two places. And it's great living in another country. Maybe you can have a phone in about settling in foreign countries. Well, you're always welcome to call in about what it's like living in Benidorm. I went there. I did go to Benidorm. 1983, that was. That was my honeymoon. My honeymoon. I always remember all these pubs were advertising full English breakfast, and you would go in there. I don't know if it's still the same now. You would go into these places in Benidorm, and you would order the full English breakfast, only to be greeted with a couple of frankfurters, in place of proper British sausages. Sausages. Yes, very, very disappointing. Alex says, DFS says it's 0% interest, seven sofas later. Do you get the DFS stuff? I don't know what that's like. I've never had DFS. Never had that. I think my mate's got DFS, and he's quite happy with his. I get my stuff from John, anything like that, John Lewis. I like the service and all that, yeah. Ashley says, where else do you do karaoke? If you have a look at my wall, Ashley, it tells you where the karaoke is, and it's always a new one up there. My main place is Central Station in King's Cross, and I do there Mondays from 8 o'clock with cheap drinks and Friday from 8:30. All right. Alexander borrows money. I hope you don't borrow money from wongon.com or whatever they're called. Have you seen the rates of interest there? No. Don't borrow money, I keep telling you. Johnny Key's going. Bye-bye, Johnny. Thanks for joining us tonight. Simon Keane says, when Ronaldo played for Manchester United, he lived five miles from me. I used to speak to him a lot. Does he really? Oh, couldn't you pass him my way? Does he want like a Mal Cougar? A Mal Cougar like me? Oh, dear. Elaine's gone as well. Good night, Elaine. I don't know what time is in Israel, actually. It must be quite late there. So good night, Elaine, my darling. All right. Good. Right. We're going to finish off now, boys and girls. We must do today's birthdays first of all. It's Tuesday. So today's birthdays. Here we go. Where are today's birthdays? Let me bring them up and then I shall disappear into the night again. Happy birthday today to John Scott. Happy birthday. Oh, now, which John are you? Are you... My friend John. Now, John, I can never... For some reason, John, I can never remember your surname. Do you know what? I'm going to write it down. There's not many... In fact, there's no one here. Because I often want to discuss things with you about radio. John used to be one of the disc jockeys on Capital Gold when it first started out. It's on the same station. Tony Blackburn was on there as well, who incidentally is now back on the BBC. So happy birthday, John Scott, Capital Gold, 1548 AM. John Scott. Now, I put your name on a little post-it note, which I shall now leave here so I won't forget now. Eventually, it'll stick it. I can never remember, because there's quite a few Johns on there, which I'm sure you know. Now, you're hiding. You are hiding your age there, John. So I'm going to estimate it at 105. Okay? Happy birthday, John, from Capital Gold, 1548 AM. All right, John, happy birthday. Happy birthday to Montana Morganstein. I hope I've got that right. It says you're 112 years old. You're looking good for 112 years old. Happy birthday today to Kristian James. To, is that Egle? Oh, it's Egle. Yes. 24 today. She used to work with me. Oh, no. Did you work with me? In that, or did you just come there? She used to come to... No, I think you just came. I can't remember if you worked with me or you just... No, you didn't. I'm sure you didn't. No, you just used to come to the Belushi's Karaoke in London Bridge. Happy birthday, Egle. Long time since I've seen you. Happy, lovely to see you on here. Happy birthday today to Billy Mac. Billy, oh, Billy Mac. I know it's Jimmy Mac, but I've changed the name, especially for your birthday today. Happy birthday, Billy. Happy birthday to the lovely Jay Shurey, who I've known for a few years, does internet-type stuff. 34? 34? I think you're a bit older than that, aren't you, Jay? Come on, dear. We're all friends on here. Happy birthday, Jay. Happy birthday to Jordan Pricey Price. 37 today. Happy birthday, sir. Looking very good for 37. I hope I look all right for my age. 53. 54 next month. Start saving. That's what I should do. Go fund me for my birthday. We can all send money. How fab! I wonder how much I'd get. How much do you think I'd get if I set up a GoFundMe for my birthday? Maybe I should do it just to try. Would you send anything? No, I thought not. You tight-fisted people. And happy birthday today to Greg Peppett. So it's those birthdays today, boys and girls. I'll give you one more chance to call in. Otherwise, I'm going, okay? 020-8144-3477. You have the length of me singing happy birthday to call in. 020-8144-3477. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right. Have a nice birthday, boys and girls. A bit late. I should have done the show earlier today, I think. Would have been better to do it earlier. Never mind. Any more messages? Ah, yes. Stella says you still get the full English breakfast in Benidorm. Real English sausages these days. Ah, good. Because I was always disappointed when these Frankfurt... And they'd fried them. They weren't like hot dogs like they do in the cinemas and places like that. They were Frankfurters, but they fried them. And they would class that as a British sausage because it was nothing like it. They should have been taken to court, dear. False representation of the British sausage. Yes. The best restaurant in Benidorm is called John and Joseph. So thank you very much for that, my darling. And one more quick check on the messages and then we'll disappear. All right, let's have a look. 54. What's £54, Stella? I don't know what £54 is, dear. That must have been, was that something we were talking about earlier? I lose the plot sometimes. I forget where I am. Simon says, next time I see Cristiano Ronaldo, I will ask him, wouldn't it be great if I could have him here and do an interview with him? We could talk about how he got into football and did he always want to do that as a child, and I could give him a little cuddle live on air in front of his girlfriend. Yes, that would be a good idea. Hello to Sun Gal, who says, roll over, have the best frankfurters. At least it's more than 50% meat, as opposed to real sausages, which are, well, not so much. Well, I don't know. I mean, I used to love sausages. What was the ones I liked? Because I've been a vegetarian now for about 4 years, and I wouldn't eat any more dead animals anymore. But when I did, it was thick Irish farmhouse sausages that I used to like. Yeah, they're the ones I used to like. let's see. Do you know that they will bring out the new £10 and £20 in the new year? Oh, really? Is that going to be a note? Is it what? As in like the £5? Don't think those £5 are not destroyable. Like, if you try and rip one, you won't be able to do it. But all you've got to do is cut. Be very careful with those. If you get a little nick in the top, like if you've got a pair of scissors and cut a tiny bit there, you'd be able to rip it in half, no problem at all. So be careful with those, all right? Someone wants to know, where will you do karaoke on a Sunday now? You're only doing karaoke. Yes, I'm not doing karaoke on Sundays anymore. Only once a month at the Golden Lion in Sydenham. I want some more time off. I want some more time to be able to do this sort of thing as well, okay? You can't just keep working and working. It's just madness, you know, and it just is to get all the time. Your money making steam for your birthday. You reckon I'd get about 54 quid if I go fund me for Chris Reardon from United Kingdom Talks birthday. I quite like the idea of that. I should try it. Some gal doesn't like the idea of a fried hot dog. It's not nice. It's really not nice. Me and her used to sit there. I can't remember if she used to eat it or not. The fried eggs, that was all right. And it had baked beans. But the fried sausages just didn't. And the bacon was horrible. Oh, my God. Well, it was just all a piece of fat, dear. All a piece of fat. Right, we're going to leave you now, boys and girls. Thank you very, very much for joining us on our little live show. A couple of people asking, when do you do your live shows? Actually, it's as... and oh, it's a lovely picture. Thank you, Stella, for sending a picture of that beautiful cat. She is beautiful. She is it a he or a she? I can't remember, but whatever. It's a beautiful cat. Some people often ask us, when do you do your live shows? They're not actually scheduled. When I've got a bit of time, I come up, I put a little message up, live show starting shortly or something like that, and then I just do it. They're not actually scheduled. It's not like 10 o'clock every whatever. You know, it's nothing like that. But generally, you get a show every day, whether it's live or recorded. All right, thank you very, very much for joining us today, boys and girls. I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye now.